The governor's Celebration of Innovation is an annual event that honors Arizona's current and future leaders in technology and innovation. At the most recent awards ceremony, four young innovators were honored. Here's a look at their research.
Last year in the Arizona Daily Star, there was a report run on turbines and then also about efficiency of turbines. So I decided to look for mass imbalance in turbines and to maximize efficiency, which is important in Arizona with our upcoming energy efficiency and also globally as we look to maximize energy efficiency through turbines. I built an instruments package that used a data logger and an accelerometer and dynamically measured mass imbalance in wind turbines. And I used a ceiling fan as a test model. And then one is able to use the law of cosines and the inverse matrix theorem to solve for the angle of occurrence and the mass imbalance of a turbine. This would be very important for wind turbines in preventing rotor damage and just maximizing the efficiency of a turbine. If you can eliminate mass imbalance in a turbine, then you can prevent damage, excessive noise, all kinds of problems that result from the imbalance in a turbine. My innovation allows you to mount with two small fixture screws a very small package that uses a data logger and an accelerometer and then records to an SD memory card the mass imbalance and the angle of occurrence at which the imbalance occurs on a turbine. My project is very, very compact and very easily mountable and is a different approach because it uses two simple equations to solve for angle of occurrence, and then it can use up to multiple blades to fix the mass imbalance, and you can disperse the weight that you need to shave or add to the turbine to dynamically balance the turbine.
The purpose of my innovation that I created was the development of an original design for a fiber optic based display backlight. My initial motivation was a desire to create a textile-based display system. Textile in the sense that it was flexible, durable, and efficient in its operation so that it could be woven into, say, a shirt or have a lot of the attributes that a typical textile has. The engineering goals revolved around the efficiency, flexibility, durability, cost effectiveness in production, and an enhanced viewing angle in the textile display. After performing multiple tests, which include luminance measurements, chromaticity evaluations, and viewing angle assessments, I came upon the conclusions that the display system which I had created provided an enhanced viewing angle, more flexibility than common liquid crystal displays we have today, and a more durable system as well. Some of the end uses of my innovation currently would be within large-scale display systems, which could possibly be flexible or solid state. One exciting aspect about the innovation is that it could potentially allow for the next generation in 3D display systems, where an object could be viewed at all angles from all sides by an observer walking around the cylinder itself. I'm still continuing research on my project, and I'm planning to become involved with the USC Stevens Institute of Innovation in order to develop the project into a future business plan and future product.
I found that a hexose, which is a type of carbohydrate, is metabolized at a speed that's related to how much energy it would make for a yeast cell. So from this, I was able to get a certain type of mathematical equation, which gave a lot of new insight about how these sugars are metabolized. I looked at these sugars and I found that the rate that they're metabolized is proportional to how much energy they would make for the cell. So this can be modeled by what's called a differential equation. And solutions to this equation look like these sample curves. So this would show, with respect to time, how much of the molecule entered the cell. I found that the amount that's metabolized is equal to some constant times the rate of transport. With this new information, we can now synthesize a new type of hexose that would give a cell more energy with less of the actual sugar. And this could be implemented for not only everyday nutrition, but also for metabolic disorders like diabetes and obesity. My dream job would be using my research and applying it to some field of science and getting to do a lot of math, which is what I think is really cool.
I decided to pick a topic, the topic of hand gesture recognition. And for it, I created a very simple hand gesture recognition system that I could experiment with and play around with in order to see what could be done to make it faster and more intuitive. My technique uses a vision-based technique, and basically using an image from the camera, it tries to extract information about the hand from it. After extracting the hand, which is basically extracted using a profile that has to be generated of a user's skin color, it uses a bounding box to detect the state of the hand. And from there, it uses the motion of the hand to find gestures and do tracking to control stuff like cursors and things such as that. I actually had a demo in which you could use the clench and the cast gesture to signify clicks and unclicks on a mouse. And from that, a user was able to move windows and play simple games on a computer using only their hands. For a controller, you would have to learn that this button does this button does that. You kind of like have to do combinations. And that's kind of confusing for most people. But with something such as the Kinect, all you do is like replicate the motion that your character would do. And the end goal is to like make it easier for like basically anyone to come up. They don't need to learn like a control scheme. If a true hand gesture recognition system could be implemented that everyday users could use, it could be incredibly beneficial for just everyday computer usage. For example, in the movie slide demo, someone could select items from any sort of list or any sort of queue. In the map demo, someone could navigate Google Maps or Yahoo Maps just by moving their hand and possibly rotating it, zooming in. And even in the drawing demo, artists could like have new content creation tools that have new ways of interfacing and allowing them to create objects more intuitively.